Robert David, the president of the association.
Yeah, hello.
The meeting is
nice to see you.
She will do the introduction to serve the prize winners.
Mr. President?
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Josh just walked.
Okay, this way?
Okay.
This is Mr. Dennis Cook.
Hello.
Let's see it, Dennis. There you go.
Nice to see you.
Coal miner and his mother.
Oh, well.
Thank you.
Mr. President, congratulations to you.
Mr. Mackin became the father of 3 years.
See your wallet?
You know, they're gonna wanna see that neck.
Oh, okay.
You remember.
All right, there you go. Thank you, Ron.
Good.
Thank you.
Show it to them.
Thank you.
This is Mr. Larry Moore.
Morning.
Hi there. Nice to see you. Trying first to figure out what
it is. This is during the fall report. It's Nick Marcosa Mendez. He was here at the LAS, and then he borrowed a camera from one of them.
Looks like Santa Barbara.
This is it.
Looks like Santa Barbara.
I got this assignment. The last time I was here was a picture. I don't know if you recall it, of the frozen waterfalls with the ice climbers.
Oh,
so this is a sort of makeup for it.
Well,
yes.
Just me, standing over the track. There's moonlighting. Thank you.
Congratulations.
Mr. President. Andrea Yeager, third ranked tennis player in the world.
Hi,
Nick.
Nice to see you again.
Nice to see you.
Sorry, we don't have a picture to show you or video tape. They can bring their video tape.
Chester Moon.
President, this photographer is the one who took the pictures of the plane crash, the rescue, Lenny Scott rescuing the.
It's right in front of me.
Looking forward to seeing you at the dinner. Well, I'm dropping by. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Thank you. Just trying to do a group here.
And all right, big happy smile. There we go. Very good. And one more. Okay, very good. Thank you.
I've told this story so many times. I've got to tell it to you because I haven't told it to you. To all audiences that should hear it, when he said, get in the center, 7 years ago in Hollywood, Frederick March, when he was really a top star. And every once in a while, there'd be some occasion where there'd be a group of movie stars and photographers in the picture. Freddie March never went for the middle, went for that end. Somebody once asked him why he always got over the end. And he said, the caption always reads, reading from left to right. But he had one other thing. He was absolutely, unlike the parts he played on the screen, he was an extrovert completely. In those pictures, and now don't you dare get me to it.
I heard the story before.
It's a sight gag. Just before that camera clicked, Freddie March would let out a yell, and he'd go, ha! See, they did it. That'd be their prize winning to help him in retirement. But he'd do this, and the picture would end up with him over there in the end with a great big smile, and everybody else in the picture going,
thank you.
I thought that would be appropriate for you. I never had the nerve to do it. I just get in the middle when they tell me to do it.
Thank you very much.
Well, listen, it's a great pleasure to see you. Congratulations on all those photos. They're
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Chargé in Denmark.
How do you do? I used to go to my country some years ago and had a very pleasant time.
Ambassador Great Britain.
Good to see you.
Ambassador France.
Nice to see you.
Ambassador of Italy.
Yes.
Ambassador of Turkey. Ambassador of Iceland. Ambassador of Luxembourg. Ambassador of Belgium.
He's been very circumspect about not mentioning that. Studies and as a former Assistant Secretary of State. But we've just completed some rather extensive consultations with the heads of state in your countries regarding our dealings with the Soviet Union in the area of arms control, and particularly the INF proposals. And I have been very pleased by the reaction and cooperation and the unity that seemed to exist there. Paul Nitz, as you know, has proposed an interim agreement that we will limit our deployments of the Pershings and the cruise missiles if they will cut back, Soviet Union will cut back on theirs, and reduce their forces to an equal, and I might add, verifiable them on a global basis. We view this as a step, however. This is not abandoning 0-0. That was why from the very beginning I always had a line in my remarks to the effect that we negotiate any reasonable proposal. We knew the difficulty of obtaining the other, but we will continue to try for 0-0, but in the interim, rather than go on with a stalemate and just be talking, we're going to propose reduction in numbers of missiles. We have not proposed, made any proposal with details as to numbers as yet, but Paul Mitzi has also asked, and they've agreed to resume the negotiations and shortening the recess resuming on May 17th instead of waiting for June 30th. And,